alone.
What the?
sorry, Harriet, I forgot all about it. Ready to work?
Yeah, ma'am. Tell me what to do.
Well, let's see. Kitchen dishes need washing. Our bed needs to be made. Bathroom needs cleaning. Furniture needs polishing. And this floor needs sweeping.
I'll get right on it. Anything else?
Side of the island. Do you know anything about it?
I've never been in those woods. The trail's washed out. Cyrus has, though. Go ask him.
Okay, I will. Thanks.
Anything else?
Yeah, one more thing. Could you please empty the waste basket?
Yep. Anything else? By the way, I see you carrying around that newspaper. You want me to throw it away for you?
Please, would you? Keep your secrets to yourself. Trust no one. Seems like there was more here before.
Those tarot cards you give me?
Uh-huh.
Well, it's time to do a reading. Right now.
Well, okay. What is it?
Well, of course, it's all an interpretation, but Well, all right. This card in the middle is the fool. That's you. The fool is surrounded by all these seven other energies. This card, that's the lovers. That means that the fool is gonna have to make a choice. An area of love. Now normally that ain't necessarily so bad, but all these other cards surrounding that thing. Well, these two cards, that's justice and strength. And that's good, because the fool can use them to help out with rational solutions and a balanced mind, and courage, strength, and determination.
Sounds like I'm heading off to battle.
You might be. Take a look at these other four cards here. The worst four cards in the deck. The Hanged Man. The Tower. The Devil. And Death. The Hangman. The sacrifice is gonna happen. Transformation's gonna happen.
So what's the verdict?
That's hard to know, actually. Because, you know, it's all in the interpretation. But off the top of my head, I'd say that you're gonna have some big trouble with your honey. Evil's got him. He's gonna change. You're gonna have to muster all the strength and courage that you have to fight it. There's gonna be a sacrifice. And then, you're gonna have to use your wits to win.
Well, thanks, Harriet. That was very interesting.
I know that you think that this is all just a bunch of hogwash.
Now, Harriet, I really appreciate you trying to help me, but I just don't believe in this stuff.
Well, now, all I know is that there's some bad trouble around here. You just better watch your backside.
Fine. I will.
Thank you.
here, you stupid cat. Just want to play with you is all. Stupid kitty cat. I run away, that's all I want to do is play.
Yes. Cyrus? Cyrus, what are you doing?
Nothing.
What were you doing with my cat?
I was just playing with it, is all.
Cyrus, don't play with him, okay? I could see a little building in the woods. I was wondering, have you seen it?
Yeah, it's over there.
Well, can you show me the way?
Well, the trail's all washed out. Now, usually what I do, I just jump over it.
But where is it, Cyrus?
Over there. Oh, okay. I'll show you. Come on. Follow me. There you are. I've been waiting for you.
I'm sorry, Cyrus. I tried to hurry.
Oh, that's okay. See? There it is. Just like I told you. Come on.
Oh, I don't know, Cyrus. It's kind of dangerous. Isn't there another way?
No. There you go.
You're amazing, Cyrus. I can't believe you did that.
Of course I did. I'm strong. See?
Wow. Boy, you are strong.
Yeah, I know. Ma always tells me that I have more muscles than brains.
Yeah, well, your mother was right, Cyrus.
Heck. It ain't nothing.
Cyrus!
Oh, I gotta go. Thank you.
a tarnished brass lens piece.
Can't see anything. Oh, it's missing a lens piece. That other window there by the tower room. God.
Tom, what are you doing here? Did you want something? Why did you... Sultan. Sultan. Lead me to my plants.
Yes.
Wonder who that could be.
Hi. Yeah, I'm Mike. Your caretakers let me in.
Oh, great. I'm going nuts without a phone.
Yeah, I can understand that. This is quite a place you got here, man.
Adrian. Yeah, it is quite a place, isn't it?
I better get back to work.
Okay.
Who is that woman? Who is she?
That's Harriet.
I don't want her around our house, so you had better get rid of her.
September 14th, 1889. Dear Diary, I grow increasingly fearful of Zoltan. I feel the burn of his eyes upon me as he watches my every move. Did my little girl have such fears? Did she suffer when he snuffed out her baby life? How could people believe him when he said it was an accident? It was no accident. But, dear Diary, Zoltan wasn't always like this. I remember, not so long ago, when he was loving and gay. He was overjoyed when Sophia was born. I know, I remember. But after his trip to Paris last year, he changed. Something happened to him. I don't know what. Now, all I have left are my plants. I spend most of my time in my greenhouse, as far away as I can get from Zoltan's ever-watchful eyes.
You dirty, rotten, stinking, filthy son of a bitch. You stay away from my wife.
Just what are you accusing me of, sir?
I know exactly what you're doing here.
John, shut up! I think you better leave.
Don't you ever tell me to shut up.